I'm Samir Gupta. I'm professor of medicine in the Division of Infectious Diseases at the IU School of Medicine, and I also serve as the vice chair for research. We're making positive strides. So I really do believe that by the end of this calendar year, we'll have a much firmer handle on how to properly treat patients with COVID-19, and maybe also be able to determine what types of treatment would be better suited based on individual patient characteristics. We were testing the use of remdesivir at two different durations of treatment at 5 or 10 days in patients who were hospitalized but didn't require extra oxygen. The second trial was very similar to the primary trial run by the NIH that compared remdesivir with placebo in severely ill patients. But in this trial, severely ill patients through the IU Health system, defined as requiring extra oxygen or being on a mechanical ventilator, the trial was determining if 5 or 10 days of treatment was preferable in terms of helping the patient recover as well as limiting side effects. Doing these proper randomized trials will give us really good evidence if a therapy, in this case remdesivir, is truly helpful and also gives us a fair assessment of the side effects of the drug compared to not receiving it. So if the entire trial was done just here in Indianapolis, well then that's great. It would answer questions about people with COVID-19 here in Indiana, but it may not pertain to patients in Europe, in Asia, in South America, because there are differences in environment, in genetics, in local customs of how to treat infectious diseases. So in a worldwide trial, if we still see a positive beneficial signal or result with remdesivir, that really means something. That means that we can use this treatment anywhere in the world and should get similarly good results. The next phase of the developmental program here is to determine if perhaps combination therapies will be even more effective than just giving remdesivir alone. I'm just so proud of our team, and it's a testament to the single-minded mission the whole school and the university has had over these last 3 months to help everybody deal with this pandemic.